Good morning, children. So today let us start with the part 5 of human reproduction chapter. So today we are going to cover menstrual cycle. Okay, this menstrual cycle, that is the reproductive cycle of female primates. So that you call that as menstrual cycle. The first menstruation, it begins at puberty, that you call that as menarche. And the menstrual cycle is repeated at an average interval of 28 to 29 days. So here the ovum released, one ovum, it is released at the middle of each menstrual cycle. That is ovulation, it occurs at the middle of each menstrual cycle. Now let us see step by step. So it includes different phases. The phase, first phase, we call that as menstrual phase. So during this time, the menstrual flow occurs and it lasts for about 3 to 5 days. Breakdown of endometrial lining occurs during this time. Okay, so endometrial lining along with the blood vessel. So that's why, so the menstrual flow occurs. So it occurs only when there is no fertilization. The ovum is released but there is no fertilization. Then only the menstrual phase occurs. When there is lack of menstruation, it indicates pregnancy. The second phase, you call that as follicular phase. The menstrual phase is followed by follicular phase. Here the primary follicle, it becomes graafian follicle. Regeneration and proliferation of uterine endometrium occurs. So in during menstrual phase, the breakdown of endometrial wall occurred, no? The regeneration occurs during this time. LH, that is luteinizing hormone, and FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, level increases in follicular phase. Means development of follicle occurs, that's why you call that as follicular phase. All the repair, it occurs during this time. The level of estrogen also increases. It lasts for about 5 to 13 days. And the third phase, you call that as ovulatory phase. Because during this time, the ovulation occurs. So that's why you call this as ovulatory phase. Normally, it occurs during 14th day of menstrual cycle. Then next is luteal phase. Here the graafian follicle, when after release of ovum, no, it is converted into corpus luteum. So here the ovulation is completed, then later the remaining portion, the remnant of graafian follicle, is converted into corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum, it produces the hormone progesterone. You can see during this time the progesterone, that is the red color line, they are given, no? So the progesterone level increases. Graafian follicle, you know, it produces estrogen hormone, and the corpus luteum, it produces progesterone hormone. The progesterone, what is the function of progesterone hormone? It maintains the uterine endometrium. You can see the uterine wall, it is degraded here during menstrual cycle. Later proliferation occurs and the proliferation is more, and later you see here when the progesterone level increase, then automatically the endometrial wall lining thickness also increases. Okay, that is the function, mainly it maintains the uterine endometrium, thickness of the uterine endometrium, it increases. When there is fertilization, corpus luteum, it remains, and the menstrual cycle is stopped and the pregnancy is continued. When there is no fertilization, the disintegration of endometrium occurs. Disintegration of endometrium, it leads to menstruation. So the menstrual cycle, it ceases around 50 years of age, that you call that as menopause. Okay children, it can be asked in 5 mark questions in board exam. So here different phases you have to remember, that is menstrual phase, follicular phase, ovulatory phase and luteal phase. Sometimes by giving diagram also, diagram based questions can be asked in 5 marks. Okay children, hope you must have understood. Thank you. We'll meet in the next class.